Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And hi, my name is Nur Hidayah binti Andom and my metric card is 1915534. Today I'm going to share about Cheng Hun Teng Temple. Cheng Hun Teng Temple is one of the most notable landmark in Malacca. It was set near the Hindu temple Sri Pogyata Vinayagar along Jalan Hang Lekyu in Jongker Street. This Chinese temple is built as the oldest Buddhist place of worship in the country. Built in 1646, it is also known as the Merciful Cloud Temple. It was a Chinese temple that practicing three doctrinal system of Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism. The temple is dedicated to Kuan Yin, the goddess of mercy. A black, gold, and red robot statue of the goddess stands in the central prayer hall. So, enough with the short briefing, let us see the tangible and intangible heritage in this temple. I am always amazed with the architecture presented by this temple. Firstly, because Cheng Hun Teng's architecture reflects the skill of migrant builder and craftsmen from China's southern provinces, mainly Fujian and Guangdong, who brought along their culture, traditions, and heritage. Secondly, it was because they built the building with the principle of Feng Shui. Feng Shui is incorporating the fundamental belief that every aspect of life is closely related to attaining perfect harmony with nature. While the Cheng Hun Teng is representative of the more peasant southern Chinese temple form, there are features that depart from the usual temples found in Malaysia, such as its roof slope has a steeper incline compared to the general lower and flatter Fujian form. The flag masts are of dramatic height and much taller than the other temple. The temple has three bays rather than one found in most temples. Most of the columns are constructed in timber, erected on granite pedestals, and are no circular in shape. Lacquer and gold gilding is used extensively in the structural members and decorative fittings, and all these elements contribute to the uniqueness of this architectural masterpiece. The main temple complex includes a main shrine hall, an outer prayer pavilion, and auxiliary buildings to the sides and the rear. Now let's look at the shrine halls. The concentric arrangement features Guan Shi Yin Pu Sa in the middle. The left altar is dedicated to the goddess Ma Zu, Ma Cho Po, the guardian of the fisherman and seafarer. On the right are the deities Bao Sheng Da Di, the divine physician and guardian deity of well-being, and Xie Tan Da Di, Guan Gong, is the god of justice, righteousness, and loyalty, and his assistant Guan Pin and Zhou Chang. The deity Tai Sui, god of the worldly human welfare, is also located in this altar. The central altar is dedicated to the goddess Guan Shi Yin Pu Sa with the images of Shakyamuni Buddha and deity Di Zhang Wang Pu Sa in the foreground. Next, this temple have an opera house located directly facing the temple across the road. China's opera shows are held annually during the Guan Yin birthday celebrations. The opera house was constructed in 1890 and all shows are open to the public. A fully air-conditioned multi-purpose hall is located within the opera youth compound. It was named as the Teng Chu Hall in honor of the six Teng Chu's leader of the temple who served the temple during the period of 1824 to 1915. Lastly, the seven moon prayer, which is Zhongyuanji, as well as cultural talks and meetings, are frequently held in this hall. After wandering around in this temple, I think that this temple could be even greater if they provide few more facilities. Since, to be honest, I'm not really satisfied with the services given and also the facilities there. So, after the visit, I came up with the idea of the facilities that should be provided and also some mechanism. So these are the facilities and services that should be implemented in this temple. The first one is providing a ready tour guide. The second one is provide more than English and Chinese language. The third one is provide informative television brochure. And lastly, a staff that works specifically for cleaning. So, how are they going to apply that? These are the mechanisms that should be implemented. The first facility that should be provided by this temple is a ready tour guide. The tour guide in Cheng Hun Teng Temple is hard to get, and the tourists have to make an appointment in order to get a tour guide. This is important because the Cheng Hun Teng Temple has lots of altars, and not all the tourists understand the Chinese words. They want to know and differentiate the differences between the three main religions that are well known in that temple. So, they need to hire a tour guide that is always ready for the information about the temple. This temple also need to provide more than English and Chinese language. The tourists need to have a tour guide that is fluent in Malay language and at least the third big race in our country, which is Indian language. The management of that place could hire someone that can speak in Chinese, English, Indian, and Malay. This dialect of ready tour guide, it will ease the tourists if they provide the informative television that can be useful for the tourists to check for the information, such as the inside map to know which area they can enter and which they cannot. They do have the inside map in the guidebook, but we need to buy the guidebook, and I found that the map isn't really helpful. It is pretty hard to even find a toilet without this information. According to my visit, I cannot find the toilet because I do not know who I can ask for it, and there is not even a sign. I even cannot differentiate all of the altars. It does have different status for each altars, but the management should provide translation for the name of each of the altars. Next, this temple would be really great if they also provide a brochure. It is because the process of making brochure is really fast and it's also very cheap. It will be easy for the tourists to carry it everywhere because it can be folded, the information also attractive and informative enough to make the tourists come to learn even more about this temple. The brochure can be ordered online at the Flyers Brochure Printing Melaka, Malaysia. They provide lots of brochure samples to choose. The temple is also quite dusty. Their pantry site, which can be seen as soon as we come in the left wing of the temple. The place for the worshipping are also a little bit dusty. So it is a must to have a worker that will focus on cleaning the temple, since that place is always being the attraction for tourists. So the management should play their role with hiring a worker to keep the place in a good quality and a healthy conditions. I also met a brochure. This brochure is just a sample I met. It's a very simple three-folded brochure with some basic information about the Cheng Hun Teng Temple. In this brochure, I already provide a map that shows the nearest place to stop, such as a cafe, so that the tourists will easy to get food and drinks near the temple's area. In conclusion, as a Malaysian citizen, I really hope that this valuable place will be preserved and can be passed by to our next generation. The donation box is always there. I hope the local residents and tourists will give even a little amount of donation to this place. I also hope the Malaysian government will give more financial funding to this building. So that is all from me. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.